In this module, we will study some of the basic biological terminology. And this module is basically for the computer scientists who don't have the background of natural sciences. So in this module, I think it will be a good idea to start with the basic knowledge of the cell. To gain the knowledge of the cell and its organelles, it is better to study the human and its systems. So here we can see there are many specialized systems in the human body. For example, we can see here the respiratory system. It consists of lungs, arteries, veins, and blood. And the main function of the respiratory system is to transport oxygen to various parts of the body. Similarly, we can see here the specialized digestive system, and the main purpose of this system is to convert the food into various smaller particles that can be absorbed in the body. So we can see in more detail that these systems are further composed of smaller cells. So we can see here the cells of the cartilage, the bone, the blood cell, adipose tissues, etc. They all composed of cells. So we can see here very small cells. So this is again the larger view of the cells. So we can see very clearly the skin cells, many small skin cells. Here the liver cells, they are composed of cells. The heart muscles also composed of cells, and of course the red blood cells. So here is the general structure and the organelles of the cell. So we can see here the cell is composed of many small organelles, as we have seen in the human body. The human body composed of many specialized systems. So in the cells there are many specialized organelles, different organelles, they perform their specialized functions. To get the more insight concept of the cell, here we can see left side and right side boxes. So question is, which box provide best access to very specific screws and nails? So if your answer is right, you are absolutely right, because in the right box we can see very specialized compartmentalization of the nails and the screw, and we can pick the nails to perform the very specific function. So here we can say that cells are also divided into specialized organs called organelles. So this is the cell membrane. Cell membrane is also called the plasma membrane. Its chief function is to regulate and control transport out and in of the cell. So it forms a boundary between outside of the cell and inside of the cell. So inside of the cell means cytoplasm. Here we can see a double layer of lipids, which is called lipid bilayer. Also we can see proteins embedded in the membrane. So the protein embedded in the membrane, as well as the carbohydrates attached to those proteins. Cells have different structures that perform different functions. So the next is the most important part of the cell is the nucleus. Nucleus controls many different activities of the cell. Within the nucleus is DNA. And within the DNA is stored the genetic information. DNA is very important. That is why it is surrounded by the double membrane. It has a small pores called nuclear pores. Anything that enter or leave the nucleus has to pass through the nuclear pore. Within the center of the nucleus, a structure called nucleolus. And within the nucleolus, ribosomal RNA are synthesized, and in turn they form the ribosomes. And some of the ribosomes, they are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum is divided into two One is the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Here we can see the membranous structure of the endoplasmic reticulum, and we can see the small particles on these endoplasmic reticulum. So due to the presence of these particles, which are ribosomes, is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. On the other hand, there is a part of the endoplasmic reticulum that are devoid of these ribosomes. So we can see here there is no ribosome present on this part of the endoplasmic reticulum. So it is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So the main function of this smooth endoplasmic reticulum is mainly to store the proteins that are exported out of the cell. So in this module, we have seen that cell is divided into many specialized small organs called organelles. And these organelles perform very specialized functions. And for example, in this module, we have seen the functions of cell membrane, ribosomes, nucleus, and some other organelles. So these organelles are the basic performing functions of the cell.